now that we have our AC power and our siren connected, we're going to land our keypad wires. The Destiny keypads, as we said before, have six connectors. Four are power and data, two for power, two for data, and then they have an extra two because the Destiny keypads had built-in speakers. The Honeywell keypads that we're going to be putting in, a 6160V and a Tuxedo Touch WIFI, are simple four-wire connections. So we're going to take two of our connections on here. I'm going to choose the blue and white and yellow and white, and we're just going to wrap these down. We're not going to use that. And we're going to run our two keypads here in parallel on our ECP terminal, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So on the board here, we've got ground, aux power, green, and yellow. Just power, or negative power, positive power, data in, data out. So when you run in parallel, that's a home run from each keypad. And we just want to make sure that when we go back over to our keypads that we know which wire we've connected to which terminal. So once we've made our connections, we're just going to label on a piece of paper to make sure that we connect the right wires onto our keypads once we get to that part. So for now, I'm just going to choose two colors. We're going to go blue. We got our two blues. We're going to make these the ground connection. Negative power. So these get landed on the same screw as our siren. Screw it down nice and tight. Good connection. And we're going to go and choose our next color. Green. Again, the color doesn't really matter for what we're doing since it's an existing run. The important part will be to make sure that we're landing the proper colors on the actual keypad once we get to there. So we're going to go green to power positive or aux power. Nice and tight. Gonna go and use yellow for our, well, we could have been smart and used green on green and yellow on yellow. What we'll do is we'll go yellow to yellow. We already landed the green, so we can use our white and green to go to the actual green terminal. Got yellow connected, and so we're left with our green and our white. Gonna land that under green. Nice and tight. And we now made our two keypad connections, which used to be six wires. And now for the Honeywell, we've got our simple four wire. So we've got, again, our transformer, siren, two keypads connected. These are our battery charging circuits. We're going to leave that off. We're going to deal with powering the transformer later. We're going to start to land all of these zone terminals. The VISTA 21IP comes programmed with zones 1 through 8 enabled. Zone 1 is set up as a fire zone by default. Two wire smoke detectors attached to this first terminal get an auto power reset when you disarm the system. So if you are going to have wired smokes, you should always use terminals Z plus 1 and Z1, or Z1 plus and Z1 negative. For us, we don't have any smoke detectors tied into this system, so we're going to use that as a simple door window zone. And like I said from before, because we've got 14 zones here and our panel is only 8 zones, we're going to use what's called zone doubling. You can't zone double zone 1 because that's the fire zone, but we can zone double zones 2 through 8 to get a total of 15 zones from our base panel, and that's what we're going to do to break out these zones. Once we have it connected, we'll have everything landed, and we'll have two of these individual zones landed on 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll have a single zone on zone 1. We'll have everything wired up at that point. We can go deal with our keypads, add in our GSM card, which gets snapped in here, throw on power, and then we'll move over to start adjusting the keypads and finalizing the installation. So the hard part will be navigating all of this. Luckily, we've got it labeled, so hopefully we can sort this out and it won't be too bad. So we're going to try to find, keep things neat, our front door. And we do have a list of our zones from originally. So zone 1 is the front door. Try to keep these wires as neat as possible. We got zone 14 right here, working down. Set aside zone 14. We've got zone 13, set that one aside. We've got back window, this is zone 4. So some of these zones, when they're just a single loop, like if it's coming just from one door, you would just have a two-conductor wire similar to this. You'd have your two-conductor, your black and your red. Other zones, when it's multiple windows tied to one loop or one zone, it'll look like this. You'll have so this one is labeled back window, zone 4, and you can see in our house we have three windows that are in the back window zone. So you can see that there's, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 actual connections. And they're run in series. So normally you can run them in series out in the field, or you can take each individual home run back to the panel and run them in series here. So you get your black and your red, you've got your red going to your black. Again, from here, we've got our red to black, and then we're left with a red and a black to land as our zone. So this is our entire back window loop made up of four different individual openings out in the field. So that's just to demonstrate a way to do a quick series run right at the panel. So again, we'll set this aside for now. That's zone 4. This one is zone 2, front window right. There are three windows in that area, so that's again a three loop connection tied together. Here we've got sliding door, and that's two different sliders, so that's connected. We've got zone 6, bathroom back, This is zone 10. This is zone 7. Trying to isolate down to zone 1 here. We've got zone 12. Front door. Believe we found it. Oh, no, French door, zone 4. Let's see. Here we go. Here's our zone 1. So again, we've got simple connector, door window sensor on our front door. We've got a black and a red coming from the zone. Our negative has our resistor. And again, the value of this resistor on the old Destiny board is not the same resistor. So this is the most common issue that people run into when they do a panel swap out, is matching the resistor value. So a VISTA 21IP board needs a 2K resistor when you're doing normal connections here. Zone doubling uses a little different value. We'll talk about it in a second. But we're going to need, for this zone 1, a 2K resistor to land it to these terminals. So I'm going to go get my resistors. We'll be right back and we can start to land all of these zones. So we are now going to add zone 2. We've isolated our zone 2 here. It is 3 separate windows in the front of the house, 3 separate loops run in series here at the panel. You can see they've got the dolphin connectors, which are the connectors I mentioned earlier, connecting in series here. And we've got our black, our red. I've cut off the resistor. Now we're just going to splice. Splice our wire here to our resistor. And this time, because this is going to be a zone doubled one, we're going to use our zone doubling kit. Open up our baggie here, and you can see right on the bag, they reference that the 3K is orange, black, red, gold, and that the 6.2K is blue, red, red, gold. So when you open this, there are two sets of 8 resistors, and very important to match the colors. Keep this as a handy reminder for which one is which. And always the low side of the zone. So again, with zone doubling, we're going to use our two zone terminals for zone 2, ground and ZT, or Z2 rather, is going to be both zone 2, and it's also going to be zone 9.